Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of Let's Taste with the Intrepid Wino. My name is James Scarcebrook. His name is Oliver Scarcebrook. He is my seven-month-old son, and he's joining me on this little edition where I'm going to be looking at a wine that I was given by the awesome guys at Union Street Wine Store down in Geelong. Great little retail wine bar. Lots of awesome wines, but they actually made this themselves, and they made it from Ricotera Farms grapes. If you didn't know Ricotera Farms, I have tasted a number of different wines here on Let's Taste from grapes grown by Ricotera Farms. I also interviewed Ashley Ratcliffe on the Vincast whilst I was up in Mildura about a year ago for the Alternative Varieties Wine Show, doing an amazing job in the Riverland, growing a lot of different Italian varieties and really providing a fantastic service for Riverland and for people growing Italian and other alternative varieties in that region. But the guys were telling me that they bought some Montepulciano from Ashley in the 2016 vintage, and they were kind of interested to see what I thought of this. So this is the Monte by Bodega. I believe the wine is available, of course, at Union Street Wine in Geelong for $22-$23 perhaps, from memory. So let's crack it open and see what we think. What do you reckon, buddy? And of course, we're using the new official glass for Let's Taste. Quite ostentatious of me. I absolutely can imagine what you guys are thinking. So color-wise, you can see this a lovely kind of black purple kind of color. It's lovely and intense and bright. Can you smell? Smell good? Oh, my turn. Bit spicy, certainly some dark fruits. Violets. Some sort of Indian spices. Even, dare I say, a bit of dried coriander. Very, very delicate sort of peppery note as well. This kind of reminds me of more of the Marche expression for Montepulciano rather than Abruzzo. Abruzzo is a little bit juicier. Buddy, ready? Let's taste. Quite ripe, lovely, plush, dark fruits. It's certainly in the juicy realm on the palate than it was on the nose. Fresh, just a bit of fruit sweetness on the back end. Lovely, really solid drinking. Certainly has a little bit something different to say than your Shiraz or Merlot. I love Montepulciano. I think it is a very adaptable variety. You can get a lot of different styles. It's good for blending as well. And I'm looking forward to hopefully at some point working with Montepulciano myself. Solid wine here and really good for the price. Kudos to the boys. And I really do love what Ricotera Farms are doing. And I'm keen to see where they're heading in the future. I haven't yet tasted any of the Ricotera Farms wines yet. Hint, Ashley. I'm hoping to have the opportunity soon. Guys, thank you very much for watching. Obviously, thanks to the boys for sending me a bottle of their wine for me to taste. If you are keen to have your wines tasted on Let's Taste with the Intrepid Wino, please do get in contact with me via my website, intrepidwino.com. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button, share it on social media, leave me a comment below, feel free to ask me a question or recommend a wine you might think I'd be interested in tasting, and subscribe to the Intrepid Wino YouTube channel. There's lots of other videos, including Let's Tastes, and my own experiences making wine in the last couple of vintages. Come visit me at intrepidwino.com, lots of different content and ways of getting in contact with me, and please do follow me on social media, on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I'm at Intrepid Wino. Are you a bit bored, buddy? Until next time, guys. Cheers.